Introducing the all-new Hercules Beetle. Oh my gosh, it's almost lifelike! And it's an action model. Press down on its back and its bottom pincher goes up, just like real Hercules Beetles. My first attempt at designing this model was with my student Lynn during a Zoom tutoring session. And then Juan Pablo Blanco Marin, the winner of my Zoom tutoring session giveaway contest, chose it as the one for me to teach. So for this new refined Hercules Beetle, I'm going to use a 12-inch square of this double-sided, I'm not sure what kind of paper this is or where I found it, but it has the consistency of printer paper. And so if you use a sheet of 6-inch commie paper, you'll end up with a Hercules Beetle of this size. So you can fold it out of commie or printer paper cut square. All right, let's begin with white side up. If you're using commie, white side up, and fold in half. We're making a Waterbomb base. Now this is a really challenging model, so if you're new to folding, this is not the model for you. But if you're up for the challenge, let's continue. And unfold and fold in half in this direction. We're making a Waterbomb base. Fold the corner to the top. Turn over and repeat. Open the big pocket, put your finger inside, put your hand inside, and push these two points together and flatten. Waterbomb base complete. Now fold the two flaps up to the top. Unfold, turn over, and repeat on this side. And unfold. And now fold this front flap up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And rotate, and now fold this corner to this point. And now fold this edge to this point. So it's like this, and rotate, and now fold this edge so that it touches this edge. And now fold this edge to this edge. Unfold this flap and fold this flap over on the middle line. And fold this edge to this edge. And completely unfold the flap, not the whole thing. Okay, so that's the crease pattern, and we're going to repeat that on the other three flaps. So starting on this side. and crease sharply all over. And unfold the flap. So there's the crease pattern. And turn over and repeat. And I'm going to fast forward this part. So the pre-creases are done, and now it's time to collapse. So we're going to open here, and we're going to pinch on this top layer, right on the fold next to the center. Put your hand inside, and pinch, 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 and pinch down here. So again, what we did, it was like this. And we just pinched on this crease and the crease behind it, right here. So we're reverse folding on this crease and this crease, and now reverse back out on the next crease, here and here. So it's like that. I'm going to open it up so you can see what it looks like. Just like that. And repeat on this side. So we're folding on this crease and this crease. And on this crease and this crease. So it's like that. And now we're going to do that again. Fold on this crease and this crease. Pinch, pinch, pinch. And pinch, pinch, pinch. And valley fold on the next crease. So it's like that. And repeat on this side. And I'm going to try to make this come to the point exactly. So I'm just going to alter these folds so that they're a little bit more exact, hopefully. That's better. And now we're going to make a square base out of this part. So, fold on this crease, and on this crease. So it's like that. And now we're going to squash this down. So open this pocket and squash it. So it's like that. And now we're going to reverse this flap on this crease. So you just line it up with this edge. Pinch, pinch, pinch. And on this crease.
make sure it comes right to the corner there, and fold it back on the next crease, here and here. And repeat on the other side. So it's like that. And now petal fold. So that means fold it in on the last crease, there and there. And repeat. And repeat on these two flaps. Voila! And as you might expect, we're going to repeat on this side. And I'm going to fast forward this part. Alright, so all done with the narrowed blintzed bird base. And now we're going to sink it. So let's fold this flap over. Unfold and sink the top. So we have to go inside like this and pinch along the square. Pinch, 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 pinch. And around. And push it in like this. All right, so here we have the sunken, narrowed, blintzed bird base. And let's reverse fold here and here. And fold this flap down. And try to flatten it. Something like that. Okay, now this point right here is going to wrap around the front layer. So just stick it in. This is to taste, but about like that. And repeat. Okay. All right, so here's the top of the Hercules beetle, and here are the six legs, and there's the bottom pincher. And we're going to begin with the lowest set of legs. So take it like this, and we're going to just pivot it into this slot right here. And just pivot it all the way as far as it goes to right there. And flatten. And repeat on this side. So grab onto it, open this flap, and just pivot it out. There. So there's the top, and we have the first set of legs, the back legs. And now go for the next set. Same sort of thing. Open up this slot, and we're going to just pivot it. And this time, let's try to pivot it so that it goes straight out. Maybe a little bit back. So it's like that. You see, we're pivoting it right on this point, and same over here. Something like that. It doesn't really matter. Okay, and repeat. So there is the second pair of legs. And for the front legs, open up this slot and same thing. And this time, make it go a little bit in front. Yeah, so we have the two layers and the two layers and the pivot. And now we're going to make the top horn. So just make a rabbit ear, and this is to taste. Pinch it. And now open it and just curve it a little bit. Kind of crimp it. Especially the end. Like that. Now on the bottom, you see we're going to make it like this. So fold it as much as it can all the way back, and now make a rabbit ear right about here, like that. And once again, you can curve it a little bit, crimp it, and crimp the tip. So the idea is that this point hits the table when you press down on it, and that's what causes this to close like that. Okay, so we're pretty much on the last stretch. So now we're going to make the Hercules beetle toes. So open the tip, and this is to taste, but just completely unfold the end of it. So it is a 90 degree angle there. And fold it behind. So it's like this. And now remake the folds. So you end up with a shape like that. And squash it. And now just narrow it. Yeah, that looks pretty good. And repeat on the other five legs. And again, I'm going to fast forward this part. Okay. So now decide where you want the joints. And rabbit ear. Just narrow it like that. And repeat. So I'm going to try to do a little crimp like that. Basically just bend it outwards and squeeze. So pinch here and pinch there. So there's the joint. And repeat on this side. And I'm going to fast forward this part. Okay. And finally, for the abdomen, what we're going to do is make a little pinch, a valley fold, right on this corner. And try to make a fold that goes right like that. Pinch. So it's like this, and now fold this little point inside to lock it. So it's like that. And repeat. I'm going to stretch these front legs down so that that way it'll look a little bit taller, and that way the action will work a little bit better. And now it's a bug battle. Battle of the Hercules Beetles. Dun, 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 dun. Oh yeah. He's got him, he's got him. Ah!
Ha 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 ha, victorious.
Ah, it's got me, it's got me. Ah, get it off me, ah! Oh.
And it can fly away. Just kidding. See you guys later.